Hi, welcome to Yellow's Y2 Studios. Come on in, let me show you around. So this is our kitchen area where we have our most beloved coffee machine and our big chandelier and a sofa and a plant, and we're walking down here. Here we have the office where our CEO is sitting most days managing the company. Come on in. This is our equipment and gear room. Currently we have about 150 items in our equipment management software. And we have all from lighting, both for video and flash photography, and we have cameras and we have modifiers and all sorts of grip equipment, dollies and stands and everything you need to make videos and still images.
Can you tell me how this equipment room is organized?
Basically we have a lighting section and we have a camera section, both still and video. And we have a grip section as well with C stands and modifiers and tools and so on, kind of divided a little bit up so it's easy to find.
What is the tidiest corner in your equipment room?
That would probably be our packing table right behind you.
What are those pictures on the wall?
Those are images of what our kits should contain. We have some phase one cameras and some Canons and other cameras as well, but for our assistants, when they need to pack a kit, if you book a kit, they can see exactly what needs to be in it. So you're not out on location and missing a single cable.
What is usually the messiest place here?
Oh, yeah, that's a good question. It would probably be over here, where we have all our reflectors and stuff like that, and also our cable boxes. So sometimes you, if you need a cable, you could run into. It could take some time to find one.
Can you tell me how this equipment room is organized?
We run this equipment room through our equipment management software. In this case, it's a check room where we log all our most important equipment parts, that be cameras and lenses and stands and grips and stuff like that. And you book them through the website.
Do you have any cool tips that you use here that other equipment managers could use or learn from?
Orderliness, I would say. Just keep everything tidy and keep them well maintained. And basically, we strive to, whenever we come back from an assignment, we unpack all the equipment and check that it's still functional. So whenever somebody needs to book something, they can be assured that it is fully operational.
So do you have any cool hacks you could show us?
Yeah, we bought these cases for things, both these big front runner cases and also small plastic cases for different items, like for instance filters. It's a big mess down here, but that's where all the filters are, and this is extra things for phase one cameras. So that is instead of just putting on a shelf, we have a messy place to put it, but we know where it's supposed to go.
How do you make sure the right equipment is on the right set and also gets back on time?
Basically trust. We tend to treat all this equipment as it's our own and not just some rental place. This is insured equipment, because we need to trust each other that we book the equipment properly and we bring it back in good working order, so that when the next person comes to book it, it's 99.9 times here.
I see there is a shoot going on. Can you show us?
Yeah, sure. Come along. In here we have MediaTek, one of our clients, and they are doing some video for the Danish National Conservatories Society. They're not shooting at the moment, but you can have a look. We do some pretty big productions out here sometimes. Our rental clients rent the studios and make sometimes some really big productions. During the COVID lockdown, because it was so tight quarters, they could actually put together a small team of people and they could do some productions for national TV and some e-sport events out here. But let me show you the upstairs. Right here on the left we have our retouch department, where we retouch all our still images, and right here next door we have our video editing suite at the moment.
Can you show us your coolest piece of equipment?
Yeah, sure. This that would be our dark room. It's right in here. Let's just plug in some light so you can see.
And what's so special about this room?
Well, everything is digital at the moment, and everything is so sharp and controlled, and we got offered this waste to let all this go. So we bought it, and we dedicated this room for the analog process of photography. It's the new thing, analog photography. So we're very proud to have that, and we're also renting this out, this area out, as well as all our other studios. But let's continue. Okay, come on, I have a few more studios to show you. We have this meeting area here, just a newly laid solid oak floor. And in here we have Mikkel. He's shooting some furniture right now for a client of ours. And the last studio is right down here, Studio 5. As this being an old industrial building, laboratory building, we are in, the floors are very rough and industrial when we moved in, and we decided to keep it that way for not everything being so polished and pretty. And down here we have a fully equipped kitchen for food photography, if that's your thing.
We have seen a lot of impressive gear here, but how do you decide on what to buy next?
It's basically by demand. We just bought some video lights, some LED lights, because we use them a lot and we used to rent them. And a company just came out with the perfect lamp for us at a price point where it would be reasonable to buy it. So we just bought it because we needed it. It's gonna be the next thing we can't live without. I mean, we just bought a dark room a year ago, and we're very happy with it. So sometimes we buy things we don't need, just because it makes us happy.
You're doing a lot of cool stuff, but what is the most annoying part of your job?
Cleaning up after a shoot.
And how does that work?
Terribly. No, I mean, it's just like you've been working a whole day and maybe gone overtime, and then you still have to clean up and pack the gear and drive back home and unpack the gear and put it back on the right shelf, and it's sometimes very late when you get home.
And what's the best part of your job?
It maybe sound as a cliche, but it's a happy client, and also to see your work and your images put in the right context where you can see that it actually works, and that personally gives me a great satisfaction to see my images outworking.
Okay, and to finish, what is a project or brand you would still love to work for?
Ooh, that's a good question. Something German, I think. Because they're very correct, I think, I believe. They like sharp, correct images. I'm a bit of an OCD nerd that way. Okay, but enough about me and the Yellows Y2 Studios. Remember the coffee machine I showed you? Turn that thing off and let's go get some coffee.